Alright, Shalom, family, to my brothers and sisters of Yasharel, blessings. I pray that you are doing well wherever you are. And to the Gentiles, those that have been grafted in through Yahusha HaMashiach, praise Yah for you as well. Praise Yah, our faithful Abba. So, you guys, I wanted to talk about something that I don't think is usually spoken about. And I'm sorry for the background noise. Y'all know my tribe, they loud, they get a little rowdy sometimes, but hopefully they're not too loud. Yeah, so for this video, I wanted to talk about the culture in Babylon. So just to give you some background, I remember, could have been a little over a month ago, but it was this ballet instructor, and she made a video. She was very upset because her students were singing some type of very inappropriate song. You know, she couldn't tolerate it. She was very, very upset and offended by what her students were reciting, and rightfully so. I agree with the fact that those babies, those little girls, should not be singing these hypersexual, inappropriate songs. It's not even right for grown women to be acting out this type of behavior, to be feeding into this wicked culture. I agree with that. But, you guys, I could not, for one second, I could not ignore the hypocrisy. Because, let's be honest, let's be real. When you see ballet dancers, what are they wearing? They're usually wearing leotards, tights, and you will most definitely see their behind. Now, I'm just going to keep it real. Ballet is a culturally appropriate form of exotic dancing. I mean, period. Like, I'm not going to cap on that, because it's complete exposure of the body. And because it's culturally appropriate, children of all ages can participate in it. And, you know, there's nothing uncovered in ballet. But because Babylon has told you that this is culturally correct, this is politically correct, this is tolerable, you know, then people are so desensitized to the fact that you have your children out here twirling in front of strangers, in front of grown men, in front of pedophiles, whether you know it or not. You know, these people are out here. They are out here, and you're preparing your children to be hypersexual. You're preparing your children to be worshipers of the flesh, of your body. And let me ask you something. Does ballet glorify Yah? Like, think about this. You have people pretty much naked, dancing and twirling around, doing splits. And let me be quite frank with you. Strippers and ballet usually are synonymous, because strippers usually take ballet classes so they can be more flexible at what they're doing. There's no difference. And people have no idea that they are prostituting their children. This is Babylon. This is Babylon culture. My people come out of Babylon. There is no difference between ballet, cheerleading, majorettes, gymnasts. I mean, these people, this is Babylon. They're literally worshiping your body when Yah has made our bodies to be a certain way for survival, for our existence, for the benefit of ourselves and each other. That's what our bodies were used and purposefully made for. You're using your body to gain money, attention, fame. That is wicked. And all of those things I named, ballet, stripping, majorettes, cheerleading, like all of these things. And people have their children participating in these things at a young age. Do y'all not know this was made for this is pedophilia content. This was like, Babylon is wicked, you guys. It's wicked. And people can say, well, you know, well, back in the day, they didn't look this bad. Back in the day, you know, cheerleading wasn't like this. But America, Babylon had to be built, right? You're talking about the early stages of Babylon. It was always meant to pervert. It was always meant to sexually degrade, to make fornicators, prostitutes, abominations, sexual immorality. It was always meant for this purpose of cultural debauchery. And that's all I'm saying, you guys. We have to be mindful. We have to be wise as serpents, gentle as doves, you guys. We cannot be ignorant of Satan's devices. You guys, come out of Babylon. And I remember when I was teaching some years ago, I remember that they were having tryouts, like, you know, like the dancing dolls that's on TV. They were trying to do the same thing at the school that I was working at. And I worked at an elementary school, you guys. This was the beginning stages of when I was saying, but y'all, I was just like, this is not right. Like, this is not right. Like, these little girls dancing and gyrating and shaking their behinds in front of all these people, in front of grown men, and, you know, in front of little boys. Like, this is what y'all want our children, our daughters, to be doing. And this is a culture of Babylon, you guys. And it's wicked. And it will be destroyed. And if you love it, you will be destroyed with it. I am telling you to repent and to come out of it. If you have children in it, please remove them from these wicked groups. Remove them from these wicked arenas. Because it is not honoring Yah. It is sinful. It is teaching your children to be hypersexual. And I was a cheerleader when I was younger. And, you know, we've been in Babylon. So we've been so desensitized to this culture. We've been so desensitized to Satan's devices. We've been so desensitized. We have drinking the abominations of Babylon, of what these Gentiles wanted to press upon our people, to keep us cursed and in bondage and in sin, to keep us from being Yah set apart people. And now that we're waking up, you guys, we understand. We understand there is a standard of righteousness. You have to be set apart from the world. If you know that your child can't go into a church and do what they do on those fields, or can't wear what they wear, you know, in those environments where they're cheerleading or majorating, if you know it's not appropriate for them to go inside of a church, even though it's not built on truth. I'm not going to get into that right now. Even if you can understand that your child going into these churches, doing those things, you know, flooding around, dancing and pop locking, you know, like the dancing dolls, you know that's wrong. Then you know there's a standard of righteousness when it comes to Yah. You know that there is a standard of humility. There is a standard of chasteness, especially as a woman, especially raising daughters. I have a daughter, and you know, I'm just like, there is no way. There is no way. Doesn't matter how talented and is and athletic she is, like, there is no way. it's okay to put our children in those arenas, those Babylonian, Olympian, pagan arenas. You guys, because that's what it is. That's what it is. For entertainment, to entertain people. You know, you guys, we have to wake up. We have to repent and come out of Babylon. Like, you guys, we have to repent. We have to repent. All of it is wicked. All of it is wrong. You know, we cannot be compartmentalized to saying, oh, this is wrong, and but this is acceptable, when it's all Babylon. When the culture of Babylon as a whole, everything here is culture, is religions, everything is wrong. And it goes against the set apart way of the Most High YAH, of what He has given to us. So, you guys, I just really felt moved to speak about these things, to help wake some of our people up, especially YAH Sherelle. You guys, we are called to be the light to the rest of the nations, you know, and our mingling and mixing with the Gentile cultures and Babylonian cultures is what has caused our people to be downtrodden like the way we are now. This is how our people got here, by trying to be like the world, doing what the world does. No, not anymore. You guys, come out of her, my people. Do not be destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Do not be destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Do not follow the world. Do not follow the world, you guys. So, okay. That's all for this video. I love you all. Shalom. And until next time.